Next question is ellipse and a straight line. So we have seen circle, ellipse, single curves, and then parabola and the line, circle and the line. Now we are going to see a problem in with the ellipse and a straight line. I will write the problem now. Find the area of the area bounded by the ellipse. Area bounded by the ellipse. So it is a standard ellipse, x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. And the ordinates x is equal to 0 and x is equal to AE, where b square is equal to a square into 1 minus e square and e is less than 1. See, we have to know about this x is equal to AE. So in the ellipse, x is equal to AE is focus. AE comma 0 is the focus. Now I will draw the figure for you. First it is a ellipse. Now we have drawn the ellipse A, B, A dash, B dash. Now, where is this? This is x is equal to 0 is y axis. So, bounded by x is equal to 0, that is y axis. And then, x is equal to AE. X is equal to AE is somewhere here, because this OA is A. See, this is x is equal to A. So, AE is, E is less than 1. They have given E is less than 1. So, this should be the x is equal to AE line, x is equal to AE line. So, OAB, CD, E. Now, which area? Area bounded by x is equal to 0, this we have to calculate. This area we have to calculate. How will you calculate this area? See, B, C, D, E, B dash, O, B, that we have to calculate. Now, since ellipse is symmetrical about x axis, we can calculate this one area and then multiply it by 2 for the bottom area. So, this is x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. Now let us go and calculate the area of the ellipse. Area of the ellipse, what is the figure? That is, what is the area required? Area required, how will you write it? I have given you many times all the 4 problems we have done. That is area of the region. So, from the figure, write the area of the region now. What is the area of the region? B, O, B dash, E, D, C, B. I have taken here. B, O, B dash, E, D, C, B. Now, this can be written as 2 into area of the region. 2 into area of the region, 2 into area of the region, that is ODCBO, ODCBO. Now I am defining this area, that is boundary I am defining. Area bounded by the curve. What is the curve? See, this is the curve. that curve name is x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1, and then the area x axis. So two boundaries we have fixed, and the ordinates, what are the ordinates here? X is equal to 0 comma x is equal to e. See, I am marking it here. X is equal to 0, x is equal to a e. Now what is the integral? That is, lower limit is 0, upper limit is a e. Then y dx, 2 into 0 to a e. What is y here? We have already done in the previous problem. That is b by a into square root of a square minus x square dx. B by a into square root of a square minus x square dx. Calculate x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. From this, y is equal to b by a into square root of a square minus x square. So what is the formula that we are using here? 2 b by a is constant. X by 2 into square root of a square minus x square plus a square by 2 into sine inverse of x by a with the limits 0 to a e. Now let us calculate the area here. 2 b by a into upper limit. Upper limit is a e by 2 into square root of a square minus a square e square. A square minus a square e square plus a square by 2 into sine inverse of a e by a, that is e, minus lower limit. Lower limit is 0 plus a square by 2 sine inverse of 0. So this quantity is 0, this quantity is also 0. Now let me simplify this. 2 b by a, understand, a square minus a square e square. See that they have given it as, here you see, a square minus a square is b square. So square root of b square. So this is b square. Square root of b square is b. Then plus a square by 2 into sine inverse of e. So this is the answer for that. Now this is a cancels, 2 2 cancels. B square e plus a cancels there, 2 also cancels, a cancels here, ab into sine inverse of e square units. So here they have given an ellipse and a line. The line is x is equal to ae. X is equal to ae is a lattice rectum equation. Do you know ellipse equation of the lattice rectum is x is equal to ae. So it passes through the focus. It is a vertical line passing through the focus of the ellipse. So x is equal to 0, x is equal to ae, you will get b square e. A cancels there, b square, and e is there, and a b is there. A cancels, 2 cancels, b into a b into sine inverse of e square units. Now we can go to the exercise problems. Exercise 8.1. So I will write the first question. They are all simple questions. You will be able to follow these things very easily. Since we have done all these problems, find the area of the region. Find the area of the region bounded by the curve y square is equal to x and the line x is equal to 1, comma x is equal to 4 and x axis. Find the area of the region bounded by the curve y square is equal to x and the line x is equal to 1 and x is equal to 4. What are x is equal to 1 and x is equal to 4? They are parallel to y axis. They are parallel to. What is this curve? Y square is equal to x. It is a right-handed parabola. It is a right-handed parabola. Here I will write the parabolas. Here you see, this is a right-handed parabola. This is a left-handed parabola. This is y square is equal to 4ax. This is y square is equal to minus 4ax. So one is right-handed and left-handed. Positive is there. It is a right-handed parabola. Now I will take this curve here. It is a right-handed parabola. X is equal to 1. It's a line. And this is x is equal to 4. Now we have to calculate bounded by x-axis. Bounded by x-axis. What is this? Y square is equal to x. Now let us name this A, B, C, D, E, F. Now the required area is equal to area of the region. Area of the region. Now you will be able to tell what is the area of the region. AB, ECD, FA. So, since the curve is symmetrical about x-axis, we will take the area as 2 multiplied by area of the region. 2 multiplied by area of the region. Which region now? ABEFA. Now, what is this region bounded by? Area bounded by y square is equal to x. Which axis we will bound? X axis. Now you see what I am doing. This is two areas that we have defined, boundaries we have defined. Y square is equal to x and x axis. Then we have to define x is equal to 1 and x is equal to 4. You can see this. Four boundaries we have fixed. Now the formula becomes easy. 1 to 4 y dx. What is y here for this problem? It is root x dx. Root x dx. So 2 into 2 by 3 into x root x with the limits 1 to 4. So this is 4 by 3 into 4 root 2 minus 1 root 1. So this is equal to 4 into root 4, 8 minus 1, so 28 by 3 square units, 28 by 3 square units. So we have completed a simple problem. These type of problems only we get for 3 marks. 3 marks questions, we get only these problems. So already we have done three or four problems here, 4 or 5 problems are 3 marks questions only. In the exercise, most of the problems except 1 or 2, all the problems are 3 marks questions only. First exercise, second exercise, we will get 3 marks questions, 5 mark questions. 5 mark questions is 1 question and 3 marks question is 1 question will be there. Now we will go to the next question in the exercise, so that is the second question. I will write the second one. Find the area of the region bounded by y square is equal to 9x, x is equal to 2, x is equal to 4 and the x axis in the first quadrant, in the first quadrant. So same question, that second question, first question and the second question are both are similar questions, but what is the difference here? Here bounded by x-axis, both the quadrants we have taken, first quadrant and fourth quadrant. There we are going to take only the first quadrant. Now what is the figure? What is the parabola? Right-handed parabola. This is y square is equal to 9x. Y square is equal to 4ax. You can see the figure here. Y square is equal to 4ax. Shape of the parabola is like this. Now let us complete the figures. Now here x is equal to 2, line parallel to y axis. X is equal to 4, vertical line. Now only first quadrant, only this area that we have to calculate. This is A, B, C, D. Only this area that we have to calculate. We don't need to calculate the bottom area because they have given it is first quadrant. So required area is, what is the required area here? Area of the region. I think now all of us will be able to tell this area, the name the area. That is, naming the area is the first step. A, B, C, D and A. Now define the area. Area bounded by the curve. So here we have to mark this curve. What is this curve? This curve is y square is equal to 9x. Y square is equal to 9x, comma x axis. So two boundaries I have fixed now. The third and fourth boundaries, you see, x is equal to 2, x is equal to 4. This boundary and fourth boundary. So area means north, south, east, west, four boundaries are required for calculating the area. Now the integration 2 to 4 y dx, 2 to 4 y dx. This is 2 to 4 y is equal to 3 into root x dx. 2 to 4, 3 is a constant. So we can integration of root x is 2 by 3 x root x 2 to 4. 2 by 3 x root x. So 3, 3 cancels. Now 2 into 4 root 4 minus 2 root 2. So this is 2 into 8 minus 2 root 2 or 16 minus 4 root 2 square units. So there is no difference between this problem and the first one and the second one in the exercise. They are simple problems. So right-handed parabola, important thing is we have to find out what is the curve, what is the shape of the parabola. Right-handed parabola, y square is equal to 9x. Okay. Next question in the exercise, the third question, let us see. That is also a parabola problem only, but you have to be careful. Third question I will write. Find the area of the region bounded by. Find the area of the region bounded by x square is equal to 4y. X square is equal to 4y, y is equal to 2, comma y is equal to 4, and the y axis in the first quadrant, and the y axis in the first quadrant. So this problem is x square is equal to 4y is a parabola. What is the shape of the parabola? It is a upward parabola. X square is equal to 4y is a upward parabola. So the success in area calculations is the geometry. That is the figure. So the graph is all right. Then we will get all the answers as very simple problems only. Integration is very simple, but we should know about this the parabola graphs. There are four different types of parabolas. You should learn, practice. If you have doubts, you can ask us. So here you see y is equal to 2. It is parallel to y line is parallel to x axis. Y is equal to 4, and the first x axis, that is y axis, and the first quadrant, you see, this is the area that you have to calculate. What is the curve? X square is equal to 4y. Now we can find the area like this. The required area is equal to, the required area is area of the region. So naming the area now. This is A, B, C, D. Now A, B, C, D, A. Now what is the boundaries for this? This is area bounded by the curve. X square is equal to 9y. The axis is y axis, be careful, and the ordinates are y is equal to 2, y is equal to 4. Now the formula for this 2 to 4 bounded by y axis, for area formula changes for y axis, it is x into dy. X, how will you calculate? X is equal to, x is equal to, you have to calculate from this. So 2 to 4, x is 2 into root y dy. So this is 2 into integration of root y is y into root y, 2 by 3 y root y, with the limits 2 to 4. 4 by 3 into, this is 4 root 2, 4 root 4 minus 2 root 2, 4 by 3 into 8 minus 2 root 2, square units. So simple problems, as I was telling, all these are 3 marks questions, so they are very easy to calculate. So same problems what is in the books only, they are asking in the examination papers. So if you learn this, already we have done, how many problems in parabola we have done? 4 problems are over in parabola. Ellipse, 1 problem is over. Now we will go to another ellipse problem. Ellipse, find the area of the region bounded by the ellipse x square by 16 plus y square by 9 is equal to 1. X square by 16 plus y square by 9 is equal to 1. So in the examples we did x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. Here a square is 16 and b square is 9. So how to draw the ellipse? See, put y is equal to 0, then x square is equal to 16, x is equal to plus or minus 4. Put x is equal to 0, y square is equal to 9, y is equal to plus or minus 3. So I will draw the ellipse now. O, A, B, A dash, B dash, X, Y, X dash, and Y dash. Now we should know this. This is x is equal to 4, and here you get x is equal, y is equal to 3. Y is equal to 3, and this is x is equal to 0. So, ellipse. How we have done in the ellipse previous problem? 4 times the area OAB. So, area of the ellipse is 4 into area of the region OABO. This is area bounded by area bounded by x square by 16 plus y square by 9 is equal to 1, comma x axis, and the ordinates are x is equal to 0, x is equal to 4, x is equal to 0, x is equal to 4. So this is x square by 16 plus y square by 9 is equal to 1. This is one boundary, this is another boundary. You can see the arrow mark, 4 boundaries I have marked. So 4 boundaries are also defined here. Now we can do the formula for ellipse, which is 4 into integral 0 to 4 y dx. So 4 into 0 to 4, what is y dx here? That is calculate this, x square by 16, y square by 9 is equal to 1, y square by 9 is equal to 1 minus x square by 16, 16 minus x square by 16. So y is equal to 3 by 4 into square root of 16 minus x square. So 3 by 4 into square root of 16 minus x square into dx. Now 4, 4 cancels, 3 into formula x square, x by 2 square root of 16 minus x square, a square by 2 is 16 by 2 sine inverse of x by 4 with the limits 0 to 4. Now this is 3 into, so upper limit you can see 4 by 2 into square root of 16 minus 16, so that is 0. 8 into sine inverse of 1, so upper limit minus lower limit is x is 0, so first term is 0. 8 into sine inverse of 0, that is also 0. So what is the answer here? 3 into 8 into pi by 2, because this is 0 and this is also 0, so this is equal to 12 pi square units. What is the area? Pi into a into b. Pi into a is 4, b is 3. So directly in entrance examination, you remember the formula pi ab for ellipse, then you will be able to get the answers. Next question is fifth question, which is also ellipse. Find the area of the region. Find the area of the region bounded by the ellipse x square by 4 plus y square by 9 is equal to 1. So similar problem, this you can take it as homework. But however, I will draw the figures for you. Here, the ellipse is like this, because x is equal to 2, x is equal to 0, y is equal to 3, OAB, A dash, B dash. Now we can calculate calculate the area. Equation of the ellipse is x square by 4 plus y square by 9 is equal to 1. So, area of the ellipse is 4 into area of the region OABO. Okay. So, I will stop at this. Next, we will continue 6th question. We are going to do the problem number 6 in exercise 8.1. You can see the problem here. Find the area of the region in the first quadrant enclosed by x-axis line x is equal to root 3y and the circle x square plus y square is equal to 4. So, first there is a circle and then a line x is equal to root 3y. X is equal to root 3y is y is equal to x by root 3, which is a line passing through the origin. So, this line x is equal to root 3y and the circle is x square plus y square is equal to 4. So, where this line and the circle intersect, first we have to find that. For that, y is equal to x by root 3. In the equation of the circle, if you put x square plus y square is x square by 3 is equal to 4, x square is equal to 3, x is equal to plus or minus root 3. So, if x is equal to root 3, y becomes 1 and x is equal to minus root 3, y becomes minus 1. So, this point is root 3 comma 1 and this point is root 3 comma minus 1. Now, the area that we have to calculate is OCABO. This contains two curves. One curve is the straight line, another curve is a circle. Therefore, we have to do two areas. In the same formula, we cannot apply two equations of the curves. So, only one curve for one integral. So, we have to split the area, that is I have done it here, that is A1 and A2. So, the required area is area of the region OCABO. This can be split into two areas. One area is OCBO, another area is ABCA. So, two areas that we can split. Keep that area as A and the two areas as A1 plus A2. Now, first area is area of the region OCBO. OCBO, how to calculate this? What is the curve? Curve is x is equal to root 3y, area bounded by x is equal to root 3y, x axis and x is equal to 0, x is equal to root 3. So, this integral for this is 0 to root 3 y dx, y is equal to x by root 3. That is 1 by root 3 is constant and integration of x is x square by 2, limits 0 to root 3. Now, if you apply the limit, we get root 3 by 2 square units, 1 by root 3 for if you put x square root 3, that is x is root 3 means x square becomes 3, 3 by 2 it becomes, the lower limit is 0. Now, like that we can calculate A2, area of the region ABCA, area bounded by x square plus y square is equal to 4, x axis and x is equal to root 3 and x is equal to 2. Now, root 3 to 2, you can see this line is x is equal to root 3 and this line is x is equal to 2. So, the boundaries are between root 3 and 2 and curve equation and x axis, 4 boundaries that we have defined it here and the integration becomes root 3 to 2 y dx, y is root of 4 minus x square. See, y we take it from the equation of the circle. Now, formula for this is x by 2
root of 4 minus x square plus 4 by 2 sin inverse of x by 2 root 3 to 2. Now, substitute the upper limit, substitute the lower limit. I have done it here, and we get what is the area here, 2 by pi by 3 minus root 3 by 2 square units. Now, let us add a1 plus a2 to get a root 3 by 2 plus 2 by 3, 2 pi by 3 minus root 3 by 2. So, root 3 by 2 minus root 3 by 2 cancels, we get 2 pi by 3 square units. Next question is question number 7. Find the area of the smaller part of the circle. X square plus y square is equal to a square. Cut off by the line x is equal to a by root 2. So, we should know about x is equal to a by root 2. It is a parallel to a line which is parallel to y axis. But what is 1 by root 2? What is the value of 1 by root 2? So, we have to draw the first figure, circle figure. See, you can see, draw a circle. What is the radius of this circle? You know it. What is the radius of this circle? You see, that is x is equal to a is the radius. A is the radius. A by root 2 is smaller or bigger than a? It is smaller. 1 by root 2 is the value of 1 by root 2 approximately is 0.707. So, it is 0 and this is a. So, we get the line here, x is equal to a by root 2. Now, let us mark this area a, b, c, d, etc. We will mark. Now, which is the smaller area of this circle? This is the smaller area of the circle. Now, everything is ready. We can start the problem answering this question. So, first important is figure, a circle with radius as a, and the line is x is equal to a by root 2 is a line parallel to y axis. Now, the required area, I have hatched it, hatching is done there. So, what is the smaller part of the circle? This is the larger part of the circle, this is the smaller part of the circle, smaller part of the circle. You can easily identify that. Next, the required area is, required area is equal to area of the region, area of the region A, B, C, D, A, A, B, C, D, A. Since circle is symmetrical about the x-axis, the area above the x-axis is equal to area below the x-axis. So, we calculate only this area and multiply that by 2, only that area, that is 2 into area of the region, 2 into area of the region A, B, C, A, B, C, A. You understand this? So, this area is, we have to calculate and multiply it by 2. So, for this area, what is the boundaries? Area bounded by, area bounded by x square plus y square is equal to a square, comma x axis, and x is equal to a by root 2, comma x is equal to a. Now, the integration for this is a by root 2 is the lower limit, a is the upper limit. Y dx, y we should get it from the equation of the circle. So, what is y? So many problems we have done. We can easily calculate y. Y square is equal to a square minus x square. So, y is equal to square root of a square minus x square dx. Now, we know the formula for integral a root of a square minus x square dx. We have used it in few problems. Now, this is x by 2. Square root of a square minus x square plus a square by 2 into sine inverse of x by a. So, same formula we are using. Now, a by root 2 lower limit, upper limit is a. Now, let us use the upper limit first. 2 into a by 2 minus square root of a square minus a square. A square by 2 into sine inverse of 1. This is upper limit minus lower limit. Let us take a by 2 root 2. Because x is a by root 2. So, a by 2 root 2. Then we get a square by 2, x square, x is a by root 2. So, x square is a square by 2. Now, the next one is a square by 2 into sine inverse of a by root 2. A cancels, here you get 1 by root 2. Now, let us simplify this and get the answers. 0, a square minus a square is 0, plus a square by 2 into pi by 2 sine inverse of 1 value is pi by 2. Next, here a square by 2 is there. So, a by root 2 is there. So, what is the answer there? A square 2 root 2 into root 2, that is 4, a square by 4. Minus a square by 2 into pi by 4, a square by 2 into pi by 4. Now, on simplification, we will get all these answers. So, what is the answer here? Pi a square by 4, this is pi a square by 8. What is the simplification of pi a square by 4 minus pi a square by 8? What is the simplification for this? Pi a square by how much? Pi a square by 8 minus a square by 4. So, this is equal to pi a square by 4 minus a square by 2 square units. So, this will be the answer for this question. So, question is a circle and a line. Smaller part of the area of the circle they have asked. So, this is the method of doing it. For all these things, the figure or the geometry is important. Now, let us go to the next question, which is 8th one. The area between x is equal to y square and x is equal to 4 is divided into two equal parts by the line x is equal to a. Find the value of a. So, 8th question. So, it is a very interesting question. We have been asked to find out so far area, but they are given two areas are equal. Now, find the value of two areas are equal, find the value of A. So, see what is the figure here, you see? There is a circle which is, it is a parabola. Y square is equal to X, it is a right-handed parabola. So, as soon as you see the curve, you should be able to draw the shape. We should be able to understand the shape of the graph. So, shape is like this and x is equal to 4. It is a line here. This is x is equal to 4. There is another line x is equal to a. So, this divides this area into two equal parts. Now, let us name this A, B, C, D, E, F. Now, these are the areas. both these areas are equal. For what values of A? That is the question. Both values are equal. So now what is given to us? Area ODAEO is equal to area DCBFEA. Then find the A, what is the value of A. Now we have to take it like that itself. Now area of the region, what is the naming of this area? Let us take ODAEO. ODAEO is equal to area of the region. Area of the region BCDA EFB, these two areas are equal given. It's parabola is symmetrical, we can do this area, two areas we can do it. We can calculate one area that is above the x axis, that is 2 into area of the region. So what region this is? OADO, this is equal to 2 into area of the region, 2 into area of the region ABCDA. Now let us define these areas. So we can cancel this 2, we can cancel. Now area of the region OADO, area bounded by y square is equal to x axis, and you see x is equal to 0 and x is equal to a. So this is also is area bounded by. What is this area bounded by? Again same graph, that is y square is equal to x axis, but the ordinates are different here. Ordinates are x is equal to a and x is equal to 4, and x is equal to a, x is equal to 4. Now we get the integrals 0 to a y dx. So a to 4 y dx. So let us take what is y. How will you find out y? Y is equal to root x, 0 to a root x dx, a to 4 root x dx. Now integral of root x is 2/3 x root x, 0 to a, and 2/3 x root x a to 4. So 2/3 cancels. Here a root a minus 0 is equal to 4 into root 4 minus a root a. Now this implies 2 into a to the power of 3/2 is equal to 8. That equals a power 3/2 is equal to 4. How will you get a from this? How to get a from this? So that is the last answer is ready. A is, if you want to take a, you should raise the power of 4/2/3. So this is 2/4/3. So value of a is, either you can take it as 4/2/3. So when you want this a power 3/2, what you have to do? You have to multiply by √2/3. Then you will get a power 3/2. If you want a, you multiply it by power, raise the power by 2/3. So 2/3 into 3/2 becomes 1. So that becomes a. So, okay, 8th problem is over. We will go to the next question. Okay, next question is ninth question. Ninth question we have find the area bounded by the parabola y square is equal to x, x square, y is equal to x square and y is equal to mod x. You know mod x. What is mod x? Mod x is equal to x when x is greater than 0. Mod x is equal to minus x when x is less than 0. So, we have to first find the point of intersection between these two curves, that is y is equal to plus or minus x. Now, taking y is equal to x, x is equal to x square minus x is equal to 1, x into x minus 1 is equal to 0, x is equal to 0, x is equal to 1. So, the first point of intersection. Next, minus x is equal to x square, y is equal to minus x, let us take, y is equal to minus x. Now, what you get? X square plus x is equal to 0, x into x plus 1 is equal to 0, x is equal to 0, x is equal to minus 1. Now, the point of intersection or x is equal to 0 means y is equal to 0, y is equal to 1, y is equal to minus 1. So, the points are 0, 0, 1, comma 1, minus 1, comma minus 1. Now, we can draw the graph. So, in all the problems, area problems, first we have to find out the point of intersection between the given two curves. So, the parabola, do you know what is this parabola? The parabola is x square is equal to y, or they have given it as to confuse us only, they have given y is equal to x square, that is nothing but x square is equal to y, it is upward parabola. Now let us take the mod x line, see 0 0 is this origin. Okay, now 1 comma 1 minus 1 comma 1, so this is 1 comma 1 point and minus 1 comma 1, so area bounded by, so what are these points, let us take this as P, this as Q and this as R, S and this let us take it as A and this let us take it as B. We have to calculate this area. This area we have to calculate. Let us see how we have to calculate this area. So, the mod x line is like this. So, if you join the points, the three points 0, 0, 1, 1, so this is equal to y is equal to minus x and this is y is equal to x. Mod x curve is x is positive, that is when x is greater than 0, x is equal to minus x when x is less than 0, that is what we are given here, y is equal to minus and y is equal to x. Now you can see the parabola is symmetrical about x axis because sorry, y axis, the parabola is symmetrical about y axis. So, we need to calculate only one part of this area and multiply it by 2. So, first required area I will write. Required area is equal to, the required area is, let us take O, R, this is P, A, O. Now, carefully I will write it and see. O R P A O, O R P A O, then again we have to travel like this. Here it is B, so O B Q, O B Q, S O, so this is the area, so this is equal to area of the region, area of the region. You can see O, A, P, that is why this is named, this point is named as A, O-R-P-A-O and B-Q-S-O. So, this is the area that we have to find out. So, area between the line that is y is equal to x and the curve y is equal to x square, that area of the region. Now, watch this. This is A and this is B. O-A-P-O. 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 Q-B-O. Q-B-O. So, this is the area that we have to calculate. So, this area can be taken as 2 into area of the region. 2 into area of the region, that is area of the region OAPO. OAPO. And again, I will explain to you how to calculate this OAPO area. See, the area is you get like this, and then you have got this. So, this area that we have to calculate, for that, first let us take this area that is bounded by straight line, and then subtract this area. This area is bounded by the parabola curve, So, here area is subtraction is coming now. Now, I will write the area of the region. Area of the region, you can see here O-R-P-O, O-R-P-O, first area is O-R-P-O area minus area of the region, minus area of the region O-R-P-A-O, O-R-P-A-O. So, this area. Now, directly I will put the integrals for these two areas, A1 minus A2. First area is, what is the ordinates here, you see? This is x is equal to 0, x is equal to 1. So, 0 to 1, y dx is, y is x here, minus 0 to 1 y dx, y is equal to here x square dx. So, this is the area here, 2 into x square by 2, 0 to 1, x cube by 3, 0 to 1, 2 into 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3. 2 into 1 by 2 minus 1 by 3, 2 into 1 by 6 or 1 by 3 square units. So, even such a small area we can calculate. So, what is the question? Question is y is equal to x square, y is equal to mod x. First, solve this y is equal to x square and y is equal to plus or minus x, which is mod x. Afterwards, we get point of intersection, we can draw the graph, mod x graph, and then the parabola graph, the area bounded by the mod x and then the parabola. So, this is the area that we have to calculate. So, that has been given here, required area is equal to area of the region, OAPOQBO. So, this can be split into 2 into area of the region OAPO, because parabola is symmetrical about y axis. Next, 2 into 0 to 1, that is area of the region ORPO minus the area of the region ORPAO. So, the integrals for this is 0 to 1 y dx, y is x here. Same thing, for this curve, y is equal to x square. So, x square by 2 integration, x square by 3 integration. So, this calculation comes as 1 by 3 square units. Now, let us go to another problem where parabola and a straight line. This is also a parabola and straight line. Now, we will go to the next question. Find the area bounded by the curve. Find the area bounded by the curve. Find the area bounded by the curve. X square is equal to 4y and the line x is equal to 4y minus 2. X is equal to 4y minus 2. So, very important question. So, very few problems are there in the textbook like this. So, let us take this entrance examination. They have asked in many entrance examination this question has been asked. Now, I have told you about this, how we have to find the point of intersection. So, this is the equation of a straight line. This is the equation of parabola. What type of parabola it is? That is what first we have to understand. X square parabola, which is upward parabola. Upward parabola is that and the straight line. Now, let us try to solve this. X is equal to 4y minus 2. X square is equal to 4y. So, let me take this x square minus 2. X square minus x minus 2 is equal to 0. X square factorize if possible. Let us factorize this. X square minus 2x plus x minus 2. X into x minus 2 plus 1 into x minus 2. So, x minus 2 into x plus 1 is equal to 0. X is equal to 2, x is equal to minus 1. So, 2 points for x we are getting. So, when x is equal to 2, here when x is equal to 2, what is y? When x is equal to 2, x is equal to 2, y is equal to 1. When x is equal to minus 1, y is equal to 1 by 4. So, the point of intersections are points of intersection. So, this is the first part of the problem. Points of intersection are 2 comma 1 and minus 1 comma 1 by 4. So, without the, if you mark these two and join the line, you will get x is equal to 4y minus 2. Now, I will start drawing this figure. You can see here 0, x axis, y axis. Now, 2 comma 1, let us mark here 1 and 2 and here it is minus 1. Here let us mark 1. Now, 2 comma 1, that is this point 2 comma 1, 2 comma 1 point minus 1 comma 1 by 4. See, 1 by 4 is somewhere here. So, this point. Now, you draw a straight line. See, you have to draw a straight line joining these two points. What is that straight line equation? X is equal to 4y minus 2. So, two points you mark it and then draw the straight line. Now, the parabola curve will pass through, upward parabola it is, pass through these points. That parabola is x square is equal to 4y. Now, which area that we have to calculate? Bounded by the line and the parabola. So, this is the, this one that we have to calculate. You can see here, you can see this. What is this ordinate? X is equal to 2 and this ordinate is x is equal to minus 1. Now, let us go to the definition and we will mark the regions. That is OA, B, C, D and then P and Q. P and Q.
Now, required area is equal to area of the region. Required area is equal to area of the region. I will start from O here. This is OPB, OPB, CQO, CQO. But this area, because two curves are involved, we cannot calculate it. So, first we have to calculate the area, this area, and subtract the area here. So, I will explain to you here. You see, there is the area is like this. Okay. First, you calculate this area and then subtract this area. Then you will get this area that we are going to get. Now, what is that areas? Area of the region. Area of the region. Area of the region here. O A B C D O. O A B C D O minus area of the region. Minus area of the region. What region that we have to calculate? You see, O A P O Q C D O. So this is the area that we have to subtract. Now, we will define these two areas first. So, what are the areas here? Area bounded by, area bounded by the line x is equal to 4y minus 2 x axis and x is equal to minus 1 to x is equal to 2 minus area bounded by x square is equal to 4y x axis, x square is equal to 4y, this is the graph curve, x square is equal to 4y x axis, and then the ordinates are same for both the integrals, ordinate is same, x is equal to minus 1, x is equal to 2. Now, you can write the integration for this integrals, the definite integrals, we can write it. How we write this? You see, minus 1 to 2 y dx, minus 1 to 2 y dx. Now, how will you calculate y for this? Y for this you have to calculate from here. That is, x plus 2 divided by 4 dx, 1 to minus 1 to 2 y dx, y you have to calculate from here. Y is equal to x square by 4 dx. Now, carefully let us integrate this and then let us take this this one. See, you can see 1 by 4 is common. For both we have got 1 by 4, 1 by 4 is common. Integration of x in the first integral is x square by 2 plus 2x minus x cube by 3 with the limits minus 1 to 2. So, 1 by 4 into, let us evaluate upper limit and the lower limit for this. Let us see what values we are getting. This is 2 plus 4 minus 8 by 3 minus of 1 by 2 minus 2 plus 1 by 3. Now, this is 1 by 4 into. So, how to simplify this? These are all very simple to simplify. You see here, minus 8 by 3, minus 1 by 3, minus 9 by 3, that is nothing but minus 3. So, 6 minus 3 is 3, 3 plus 2 is 5, that is, so you can see 6 plus 2 plus 6, and here also 1, 2 is there. What is the value of that 8 minus 3? Minus 1 by 2 is remaining. So, I have added this minus 8 by 3, minus 1 by 3, which is minus 3. And 2 plus 4 is 6. 6 plus 2 is 8.
So this is you can see 5 minus 1 by 2, 1 by 4 into 9 by 2, that is 9 by 8 square units. So this problem is very important problem, because point of intersection is a different point of intersections you are getting 2 comma 1 and minus 1 comma 1 by 4. Therefore let us take this area as first calculate the upper part of the area, then subtract the lower part area, then we will get this area. So this will be, you will get on simplification 9 by 8 square units. Next problem is problem number 11 in the exercise 8.1. Find the area bounded by the curve y square is equal to 4x and the line x is equal to 3. So already we have done quite a few problems, 4 or 5 problems we have done like this. So now let us take this, what is y square is equal to 4x? It is a right-handed parabola, and x is equal to 3 is a straight line like this. So bounded by, so y, so we have to calculate both above x-axis, and they are not given as first quadrant or something, so we have to calculate both the first quadrant and the fourth quadrant. We have to calculate OA, B and C. Now this curve is y square is equal to 4x. Now the required area is, required area is equal to, what is the required area here? It is area of the region, area of the region A or O B A C O. So since the symmetry of the curve, we can calculate only area above the x-axis and multiply it by 2. So 2 into area of the region, 2 into area of the region O B A O, 2 into area bounded by the curve y square is equal to 4x, x axis, and x is equal to 0 comma x is equal to 3, 2 into, for this integral is 0 to 3. Y dx, y we should take it from the curve, y is equal to 2 into root x dx. Now integration of this is 2 into 2, 4, 2 by 3 x root x, 0 to 3. So 8 by 3 into 3 root 3 minus 0, that is equal to 8 root 3 square units. So I have already told you these type of problems. We have got 3 marks questions, almost 5-6 questions are there, out of which 1 3 mark question will be arriving. So this is a simple question, which is a right handed parabola, and the line is x is equal to 3, which is a parallel to y axis line or a vertical line. So from this symmetry, we take 2 into area bounded by the curve y square is equal to 4ax, x axis, and x is equal to 0, x is equal to 3. So this completes the exercise problems. Now we will go to entrance examination questions. Entrance examinations. So 2 questions are there here. See, you can see circle is given and the lines are x is equal to 0, x is equal to 2. What is the radius of this circle? You all know this, x square plus y square is equal to 4 means what is the radius? That is x is equal to 2, x is equal to 2, x is equal to 0, and what is this circle equation? X square plus y square is equal to 4. So it is very easy, since we know the radius of the circle, We can calculate the area very, very easily. What is the area of the circle? Area of the circle is equal to what is the area of the circle here? So we want x is equal to 0 and the first quadrant. So only this we need. So area of the circle divided by 4. Area of the circle divided by 4. What is the area of the circle? Pi r square divided by 4, which is equal to pi square units. Pi square units. Answer is A. A option is the correct answer. So here I have not done this method of integration and other things. It's a very simple question. So for entrance examination, we have to save time for us. So this is area of the circle divided by 4. Only one quadrant we have to take. So area of the circle is pi into 2 square. 2 is the radius of the circle. So this is divided by 4, you get pi square units. So first option A is the correct option. Now let us go to the next question, that is 13. Area of the region bounded by y square is equal to 4x, y axis and the line y is equal to 3. See, the problem here is the previous 11th problem is x is equal to 3 and x axis. Now here it is y is equal to 3 and y axis. The curve is same. So you see the parabola curve here, y square is equal to 4x, the line is y square is equal to 4x, the line is y is equal to 4. So this is y is equal to 0, x axis is y is equal to 0. Now you have to calculate this area bounded by y axis is x is equal to 0. This is y axis bounded by y axis. What is the formula that we have to use for this? Y square is equal to 4x. Now the formula for this is integral formula is what are the limits here? 0 to 4. Here it is 0, here it is 4. 0 to 4 x dy, x dy. So area is bounded by y axis. The formula is x into dy. Now it is simple, x you take it from the equation of the curve, x is equal to y square by 4 dy, 0 to 4. Integration is y cube by 12, 0 to 4, that is 64 by 12 minus 0, 64 by 12. What is 64 by 12 here? You can see this calculation. So 16 by 3. So x is equal to y square by 4, 0 to 4 y dx. So y cube by 3 is the integration, y cube by 12. So 64 by 12. What is 64 by 12? So 16 into 4, 3. So 16 by 3 we are getting, but there is no, so y is equal to 3, sorry. So the problem it is given as 3, not 4. Now you check, you change this, this is also 3, this is also 3. So what is 3 cube? 27 by 12, 27 by 12 is 9 by 4. The answer here is B, B option is the correct answer. Y is equal to 3 is the given problem, but I have written it as 4, so I have changed it to 4 is equal to 3, and this completes the exercise 1. Next we will take the next topic, that is area between two curves.